Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. It's Artcast 534, I believe. I'm trying to work today, but I'm having a hard time. My books are supposed to be delivered this morning, so I'm kind of finding myself walking around the house, just kind of, I don't know, having a hard time focusing on anything that's going on. I'm just sort of like a kid waking up at Christmas, I think. And just hoping that the books are going to come out and I didn't do something like really stupid and like put pages out of order or, you know, mess the coloring up or I don't even want to think, you know. But anyway, that's what's going on today. I was looking at my Indiegogo page, which I haven't really pulled up for a while. And the campaign ended on August 19th. So, about the end of August, and I'm at $7,102 right now, and I was going for $3,500 initially, which I kind of blew that out of the water, which is cool, and I ended at $5,000, and just over $5,000, and then over the last, like, 2 months, it's went up to 7,000. That's pretty neat. I like the InDemand thing on Indiegogo. It's kind of cool. It's just like, you know, a place for people to go get the book, which is neat, you know. I kept saying I was going to take it down, but I might just leave it up for a while. Once I get the books, I'll put them in my store, you know, and things like that. So, but it doesn't really hurt anything having it here, I don't think, you know. People seem to discover stuff on this site, which is cool. But let's see, August 19th and September 19th, October 19th. So it's basically two months and a little bit to get this thing shipped. And if they do show up today, I imagine I'm probably going to get them shipped out, like I said, by October. Even though it's kind of pushing it, I think I can burn through 300 packages in a week, you know. I still got a week till the end of the month, even though Halloween's coming and all that stuff, but I don't think that should be a problem. I mean, it's kind of wild that I actually went back and done this, you know. Went back into comics. I didn't really think I'd ever do a comic again. And here I am kind of knee-deep in them. And in self-publishing comics too. I kind of had given up on ever self-publishing a comic. That was a big dream of mine, you know, when I was younger. Even though I kind of worked, you know, for Marvel and stuff, it's like that was always sort of the goal I was after, but I never really got a book done to publish, you know. I had a lot of starts and then stuff would kind of get in the way. And I would let it go, and then I would start some other project. I was bad about that, you know, getting excited about something else and then going in a different direction. I don't know what that is. Every little sound out that window, I think, is like a truck pulling up. And that's why I can't get any work done today. I'm just, like, sitting here waiting for the sound of a truck coming, so... Yeah, today I went through and I made sure that everybody that, you know, contacted me with like an address change or like wanted the extra books and all that, I made sure that that was updated so that everybody should be good, you know, as far as addresses, all that kind of stuff. I've been sitting here writing some customs forms for all the, you know, international ones. I think I'm going to try to package up all the internationals right off the bat and send those. On my last Kickstarter campaign, I sent the international packages last. And that kind of hurt me because as I ran out of money, I had the most expensive packages that needed to go out. So I'm going to do those first this time. So just in case, like the crazy, you know, it's impossible for me to run out of money at this point sending these books, but just in case something like that would happen, then I'm not, you know, faced with like sending, you know, 30 or 40, $20 packages which was kind of a pain with the art book. The art book I messed up a lot of different things. A lot of things fucking, you know, went wrong on the printing end, but then also on my end. And when I did this campaign, I was like, I mean, not only I'm not letting that happen again, but it's like I'm going to make amends for like all the bad stuff, you know, that I did in that one. Everybody got their book, you know. I didn't do that much bad stuff, but I just did it. I did it wrong. I made fucking mistakes, you know what I mean? And that cost me. That definitely, you know, that made books like way later than I wanted to get them shipped out. So this time around, yeah, I just wanted to make up for it for sure. The next step after, you know, once the books get here and I finish up this Indiegogo, the next step is to get the books out to Diamond, which is like, I mean, I actually have this comic in the shops again, which is crazy. I haven't had a comic on the actual comic shop shelves since like 2000, probably, somewhere around there. And what is it, 2018? So 18-year gap. I could have grew a person in that time. I was doing a lot of other stuff, though. I was doing a lot of other stuff. I got married. I had Tristan. I totally changed careers, like, twice. Started my own painting company. I ran that for a long time, you know, never thinking I was ever getting back into comics. Then I did sketch cards for a long time. Then I sold, like, fan art. Sold nudes. Sold every fucking thing that I could think of that would sell on the internet. And just got bored with that, I guess. Made a stop motion, first episode of my stop motion thing. Yeah, I guess you can do a lot of stuff in 18 years, but I wish I would have done more projects, though, if I look back on it. I wish that the stop motion thing was like a finished project that I could go, yeah, that's that thing, and that's what that was, you know, instead of just being like a first episode to like a bigger thing. I wish I'd just made like a 10-minute short film and just called it good. Because it just kind of sucks having stuff that's sort of unfinished, you know. That's why I'm glad I ended up doing the art book. Because, you know, whether I ever get back to doing like fan art or portraiture or whatever, it's kind of like, there it is. There's what I did, you know. I did all those pieces and that's my name on the book. And that's kind of like what it is. And you can sell it. It's there in the store and that, you know. So it's good, you know. With the animation, it would have been kind of the same thing, but who knows what will happen with that, though. You know, I don't know if I'll go back and finish like the Wolf's Heart at this point. I know I've definitely had people ask me, like, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? And I don't know what the plan is there, you know, because the plan right now is to go on with the Berserkonaut. I want to take it to basically graphic novel, so I want to do like the next like 4 or 5 issues, whichever it is. I really need to like sketch out and see where it lands, because I'm thinking like it's 6 issues, but then I'm not quite sure if it is or not, because I don't like doing a million thumbnails and kind of taking that fun out of the process, because I do like kind of thumbnailing and thinking of story and then changing things and rearranging things and stuff, and that's kind of like part of like my just process of finding the story in the comic, I guess. And so it's hard for me to go like, okay, 6 issues, but that's what I'm shooting for. So I'd imagine it's gonna come in right around there. And then that would give me like a 150-page graphic novel at the end of all this. And then it's kind of like my art book, you know. It's sort of like when people ask me about the Berserkonaut and go like, well, yeah, it's this book right here, you know. But then with the Berserkonaut, you know, it's just like I've got stories in my head that go on from here too. You know, it's like, sorry if the heater's making the sound kind of weird on this one, but it runs on and off, you know. Plus the front door is kind of open because I don't want to miss this guy coming, so. But, you know, it's like I've got more stories, you know, with the Berserkonaut in my brain that might have to come out too. And like I said, you know, a few times now, like I have an idea kind of for an animation with the Berserkonaut. I've kind of thought about when I would start it. And I don't know if I could do the book and do the animation at the same time, but I've kind of thought like after Christmas might be when I start working on that, if I do. I don't want to promise anything. But I know there's a lot of people who watch my channel that really love the stop motion. And I love stop motion. And I don't know, it just might starting to happen as this thing goes, you know. It'd be fun to watch the process of it for sure, as far as like YouTube goes. It's always fun to see people building sets and making puppets and all that kind of stuff. And then I'd have a reason to talk about a lot of that stuff, and also a reason to learn a lot more about it as I did it. And when I came up with the idea with the Berserkonaut, you know, back when the initial idea, I guess, was I just thought webcomic. I was just going to do a webcomic for fun. And then I did, you know, a few pages. I think I did like 13 pages or something. And it was a lot of fun, but it just kind of was taking away from my work. And I was like, where am I really going with this? And, you know, this is, like I said, taking away from my work, taking away from my you know, day job kind of thing. Even though I don't have a day job, it's just me selling art. But it was definitely like, you know, putting pressure on that. And so I kind of just let it drop off for a few months. And it wasn't until I kind of started thinking about doing the 100 Days of Comics that I picked it up again. Because I thought, you know, wouldn't it be nice to have that finished, you know? And that whole thing came with like a stop motion short film too, you know? That was like my whole thing I wanted to do, was like to do like a, you know, like a Berserkonaut Christmas special. I shouldn't throw out like what it actually might be, but that's kind of what I was thinking, you know. I just thought that would be kind of cool because, you know, stop motion is always tied into the holiday specials, you know, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, all that kind of stuff. And anyway.
All right, so I guess so I'm sure you guys are waiting to see what 5,000 books looks like. Here we go. There, I got 5,000 stuffed inside there. What happened was they delivered it to a different house, you know, like 26 instead of 206. So they were sitting there all day, and I was just waiting up here for them to come. Let's see what they look like. There we go. Looks pretty cool. Looks pretty cool.